everybody got the 65 fastback back. Had a little situation yesterday that I want to share with everybody. Hopefully it helps some of you out in the future. This car, I got a lot of pictures, got a lot of information. Guys seem very straightforward. Do a little screenshot here in a video for you of the picture I got of the trunk of the car. The guy took a photo of the really, really solid side of the trunk. And to me, it wasn't even possible for the trunk to look any less than that on the other side because of how solid the passenger side is. But we'll come back here and I'll show you what it actually was. So this is what he sent me photos of, just this side. Now, I didn't feel the need to ask for a photo of the other side, but when I got there, this is what I found. So big hole. This isn't a terrible repair, but it was still a surprise. Nobody likes a surprise. So I'm looking over the car and it's extremely solid. Car's originally from Arizona. It's really, really solid besides that. So I said to the guy, why didn't you send me a photo of that side? Well, I couldn't get an angle on it. He's just clearly making excuses. And I said, I don't appreciate the surprise. You know, like I'm out here 6 hours away from home. Like, it's just really not cool. It's not a good way to do something, you know? And he was getting kind of hot. And I said, look, I'm not arguing. I just telling you how I feel. Put yourself in my shoes. Like, that's a big surprise. And he's saying that it's not that big of a deal. He does this body work all the time. And I said, look, I'm not looking for, you know, a big discount off of the car. You know, I felt like I was really reasonable. I said, how about you knock $500 off for that damage? Oh, no, that's crazy. That's too much. I do this stuff all the time. And I said, okay, do you want to fix that for $500? And he looked at me and he said, well, I mean, no. And I'm like, well, then I think that's a pretty fair number if you're saying it's easy and you don't want to do it for that. So in a calm way, we ended up getting a deal done. He knocked the $500 off the car, but it would have been a lot easier if I just knew about that from the get-go. We would have had that number from the get-go and there were no surprises. I would say that's 90% of sellers out here selling a car. There's always a surprise, but the time to negotiate that is ideally through text and messages when you're looking at the ad. Now, a lot of sellers will just brush you off and go to the next guy if you're asking too many questions. So it depends on what your level is and what your budget is and what your kind of project you're willing to take on. A lot of guys might have said, oh yeah, I don't care, that's fine. But the time to negotiate is when you're there. Don't be afraid to do it. Don't be afraid to say something. Don't be afraid to call out the seller. You just don't want to insult them, berate them, get nasty. Just do it in a calm way, in a way that they feel like they don't have to backpedal and get defensive and they can actually work it out with you. And that's what I did yesterday and ended up working out. Now we have the car and now the numbers work. So that's my little bit of 2 cents. Hopefully that helps people out in the future. Try and get all the info and the text messages. As we know, sometimes a good deal, you just got to jump and go, but don't be afraid to tell the seller how you feel, bring up your concerns, and just stay cool the whole time. If I could tell you from experience, if tensions get high and you start cussing at all or anything like that, it's going to go south pretty quick. So just try and keep your cool no matter how upset and disappointed you are. And it is what it is at the end of the day. It's not going to kill you to walk away from a deal. Make sure the seller knows that you're willing to walk away. It's another big part of that I forgot. I made sure he knew that I was going home anyways. I had went out there to deliver something to the port. This was kind of like a backhaul deal. I was going home with or without the car, and it made no difference to me. So make sure that a seller understands you're willing to walk away, and then they will be reluctant to let that sale slip through their fingers. So that's it. Next video will be us working on this car. It's a great car, 65 Arizona car, 289 3-speed manual on the floor. Not 100% sure what the interior color specific name is, but it's got a close to a twilight turquoise interior, maybe a little darker. It's all intact, everything's there. I think I'm only missing two accent lights in the rear quarter pieces on the back seat. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this trunk yet. We might fix it, we might not. If we do fix it, that'll be a whole video in and of itself of how to do that metal work. Other than that, car's really good. Missing a little bit of paint on the roof, which is disappointing, but still, this is a really solid car, survivor car. It's gonna run and drive. Given what happened to the red 67 engine failure, we are gonna really take our time with this motor, and we'll show you that. We're gonna take some extra steps getting this 289 running. It runs now, the seller got it running. Didn't really get it running like we would get it running, so we're basically gonna start from the ground up on that motor. We're going to tear it down further than we usually do, make sure those heads are okay, make sure the valve seats are good, the valve springs, valve guides, that kind of thing. Make sure that we're not going to end up with another engine failure due to a valve. So never doing that again. Just take the extra steps now. Title on the car, we're going to get probably, might put tires on this car. We'll see how good it runs. And then it'll be available in a month or so. And that's it. We'll see what this paint can do. You can see this car had a repaint. I think it got repainted with Twilight Turquoise. And I forget the other name of this color underneath is. I'm not sure if that's Twilight Turquoise. They had three very similar colors. So we'll see. Might get a Marty report on it. Really hard to find these cars intact like this. Been in that same family for 45 years, which is really cool. So stay tuned. Make sure you like, subscribe. And if you feel like it, hop on the website. Get yourself a hoodie or a t-shirt. See you soon.